Hi, and welcome back. In today's video, we want to talk through accrual accounting and some of the reasons why there have to be adjusting entries. And one of those specific instances has to do with how we might handle inventory. So without further ado, let's get started. Hey, everybody. Today we're going to talk about a particular kind of adjustment that can take place when it comes to supplies and supplies inventory. And if you've looked at the video that I've done that has to do with the matching principle, the revenue recognition principle, and all of that, you'll know that there are times when we have to make adjusting entries. Adjustments are very common when it comes to accrual accounting. And inventory adjustments will occur when you use a periodic inventory method rather than a perpetual inventory method. And what that means, basically, is that in a lot of companies, there are software today that will keep track real time of what your inventory balance is. Not everyone has the luxury of having these perpetual inventory systems, and therefore, there are some inventories that even in the most sophisticated of companies, they may have to actually count the inventory to true up, if you will, at the end of a period, what their actual inventory on hand balance is. And that's the example that I'm going to go through today. So here's the example that we have. So Sally knows that the original balance in the supplies account was $2,000. And at the end of the month or at the end of the period, she takes account of these supplies, the inventory, and she now only has $1,270 worth of supplies on hand. So what adjustment should Sally make? Let's walk through our thinking process again, because the thinking process is always the same. Has a financial event taken place? Yes, it has. What accounts are we going to use? All of this has to do with supplies and supplies expense. Do we have more or less of supplies? We now have less. We began with 2,000, we now have 1,270. And do we have more or less of supplies expense? We have more expense. Another added little piece here that we've got to take into account. What is the amount that we're going to have to adjust? What kind of entry would get us to the required ending balance? In this case, the difference between the $2,000 original balance, and we know we have to get to a $1,270 balance in the supplies, we will have to credit that account for $730. So now, what is our journal entry? Let's check our logic here. What we will do is we're going to credit the supplies account for $730 because less of an asset means we have to credit it. However, we will debit supplies expense because we have more of that, and more supplies expense because it has a normal balance of a debit means we would debit that account. So yay, our journal entry balances. To recap supplies adjustments, this is something that we have to do when we have periodic inventory systems. Perpetual inventory systems, we don't have to worry about this nearly as much. Perpetual inventory systems make usage adjustments as the period progresses, so we don't have to necessarily have someone manually do that. But a periodic system will require an accountant to actually make an adjusting entry. So you compare the beginning balance to your account value, and the difference is your adjustment. We'll talk to you later. Thank you.